Currently in your area, 56 degrees under fair skies. The forecast for your area. Expect fair skies Friday through Sunday with temperatures in the 70s on Friday. Coming up on the Weather Channel, we've got a lot to discuss now. As we look across the U.S., there is much to look at. Three main problem spots, too. Of course, many opportunity spots for good weather. New York City, for example, nice tour of the Midwest. But across parts of Florida, the very heavy rain continues to be a major, major issue. We'll have to think more about that. Also talk about what's going on in Texas with some stormy weather. And across the Northwest, our system should be pushing through, but packing a potent punch in the short term. Let's begin, first of all, the satellite perspective. One storm system cranking up just offshore. As it pushes ashore, the worst of the wet weather will pass us by and we'll start to see more of a showery scenario. Into portions of Texas, expect to see some additional rain. Even a few storms may kick up in the short term. And just off the coast of Florida, along the Carolina coast too, a lot of heavy rain. May see some problems for sure. As far as record highs go, we did see a lot of warmth across the plains. Very common to see a lot of warming going on ahead of a system that brings about the cooler air, big potent front. Sharp contrast along it. You pump up quite a bit of warmth across the plains and throughout the Northwest. I'd call this a warm day. Yakima, 65. Around Eugene, 67, 68 in toward Salem. We did have a lot of our warmth in the west, 59 toward Seattle. Even that was a bit above our average temperature for this time of the year. Not bad in toward Vegas. Nice day walking Las Vegas Boulevard at 70. 66 in toward San Francisco, 72 for us in L.A., and we had 62 in toward Denver. Well, a few spots were a bit above the old average. I mentioned even Denver, across the Dakotas, many spots, even parts of Nebraska, too. We talked about our records. 21 degrees above our usual temperature in toward the Twin Cities, and a bit above our average in toward Chicagoland as well. 64 for Minneapolis, St. Paul, 62 toward Chicago, 60 around New York City. Well, pretty good today. 57 in toward Boston. There's plenty of 70s there into Florida, but Tampa and Miami, not the problem spot. The problem spot's going to be right along the coast. We'll talk about some earthquake information for just a moment. Southern Cal, a 2.5, not too far from L.A., but a bit to our north, a 2.9 on the Richter scale. 2.5, just a bit to the south of San Francisco Bay Area around Monterey, and also a 2.8 parts of Northern California. Nothing for the Pacific Northwest, but looking on in toward Alaska, a 3.1. These next two pretty tough to see on your screen. They're welding illusions, a 4.8 and a 4.5 recorded. Here's a quick look at our wet weather for the west. Throughout the morning hours, again, as the system approaches, that's going to be the roughest of it. We'll be dealing with some wind and a lot of rainfall. Don't underestimate this situation, especially if you live near the coast. We're talking about some incredible wind, very, very windy at times, and also looking at some heavy-duty rain. Some spots well in excess of an inch. Many spots can see at least an inch from this. And then we'll start to see more of a showery situation. Front kind of not really that potent, more of an area of a trough, more or less kind of a little discontinuity, kind of an elongated area below pressure moving along in the northwest. Not as potent, not as active, just more of a showery situation after our system pushes ashore. Southern California, fine day towards San Diego and in toward L.A. as well. Temperatures in the 70s. Nice day downtown here, about 75 around the Civic Center. Bay Area, a few clouds for the morning commute and a few fewer clouds in toward the afternoon. Along Interstate 80 towards Sacramento looks good. Even Reno, Tahoe, fine. Ukiah and northward, yeah, we could see a touch of rain here and there. At the morning, you expect to see quite a few showers popping up here and there. Do expect to see some rain in toward Portland, that's for sure. And we'll keep the rain around for a good portion of the day. Heavier rain on through the morning, and then easing up a bit for the latter part of the day. That's the story of the West. Talked about some problems with some of the heavier storms here across parts of Texas, and even heavy rainfall into portions of Florida. Let's talk about some amounts of rain that have popped up around Florida. That's been pretty hard hit there, close to 5 inches around Daytona Beach, on toward Melbourne, close to 4 there in Brevard. St. Augustine, yeah, about getting close to 4 there. About an inch and a third around Orlando, around Jacksonville, over an inch and a quarter, even Vero Beach, along part of the southern end of the space, goes here on toward the Gold Coast, about an inch and 1600s. Other rainfall amounts, well, we picked up quite a bit here throughout the western U.S. as well. Looking at over 6 toward Olympia, that's a lot of rain, a lot of rain. 5 4/10 for Shelton, even over an inch in toward Portland, in Seattle, over 3.5. So we have been seeing our share of the rain. Severe storms, maybe an isolated severe concern just a little bit longer into Texas. And in many of these areas, as you watch the Weather Channel, you'll see information on your screen. As if you are in an area that's affected, many areas you'll see that provided. Rainfall, again, into parts of Texas may see a few spots of very heavy rain. Just a touch of winter on the way, just a few snowflakes. In parts of the northwest, otherwise the rain is the big story here. System pushing ashore, less of an issue in toward the afternoon. Northeast, great day. Honestly, a very fine day for us here. High pressure hangs on. Might see, again, problems here from our little area of low pressure hanging on here along the coast of Florida. May continue to see the heavy rain, some storms off and on throughout the great state of Texas. Even San Antonio, around the Riverwalk, could be wet. A little showerier in toward the afternoon throughout the northwest. Amounts of rain may see more than 3 inches. Parts of Texas, central Texas, an inch or greater, pretty common in the northwest. We'll see as much as that, maybe an inch, half inch to an inch, parts of Florida. That system may linger a while. Here's a quick look at the overnight lows and then the warmth, a lot of warmth around the country throughout our Thursday. In the northeast, just a few spots with a chance of some showers. Nice toward the city in Boston. Midwest, great day. Enjoy the mild air because things are changing later on in the week. Still wet into Texas. Throughout the west, again, the northwest will keep our showers hanging on. Coming up on the Weather Channel, look at the impact of all this on your week. That's with the Weekly Planner next. Please stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Gary Collins. How well did you sleep last night? Did you find yourself tossing and turning? Did you wake up feeling tired and achy? If so, I've got great news about a new and better way to sleep on air. It's the revolutionary Select Comfort Airbed. And now you can get the whole story in this free catalog and video. Inside, you'll discover a mattress so comfortable and supportive, we guarantee you a better night's sleep. Plus, you can adjust firmness on both sides of the bed at the touch of a button. Unlike metal coils that can create pressure points and water beds that can bend your spine, Select Comfort contours to your body. So, find out why over a million Americans, including me, are waking up to Select Comfort. Call for your free catalog and video today.
To get all the exciting details on this new and better way to sleep on air, including your free Select Comfort Airbed catalog and free sleep video, call toll-free 1-800-262-6767. That's 1-800-262-6767.
I've always loved working on computers, and in the Army, that's what I do.
If you never thought about the U.S. Army or Army Reserve, think about this. There are 212 ways for you to become a soldier and work at a job you'll love. Call for this free video to find out which job is right for you. And if you call 1-800-645-ARMY right now, you'll also receive a free Army t-shirt with your video. Discover the 212 ways you can be an Army of One. Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel. Currently, the temperature is 56 degrees under fair skies. Your forecast. Expect fair skies Friday through Sunday with temperatures in the 70s on Friday.
Problems aplenty for this Thursday. Northwest, we're looking at a pretty sizable system. It should become a little less active in toward the afternoon hours and a little more of a showery situation even midday and beyond. So some storms continue into Texas and just offshore. Pretty sizable area of low pressure continues to hang on and produce a lot of heavy rainfall throughout parts of the Carolinas, even toward the low country, parts of coastal Georgia, and in toward Florida. A lot of rain to come. Let's talk about some changes over the next few days. A lot of warmth around. That's probably the best part of the equation here. A couple of problem spots, but opportunity spots across the Midwest and Northeast. Our temperatures will slowly get warmer. In the Northeast, a little bit of the cool air we've endured. Not that big of a deal. Another mild day coming up Thursday and getting a bit milder, as you'll see from the temperatures in just a moment. Now, this trough just offshore, think about physics for a moment. Something kind of down and around like that. Of course, keep the area of low pressure cranked up, so we have a bit of a trough in place, an area of low pressure on the move that will scoot along and give us at least a brief break, very brief break in the Pacific Northwest. The other big story will be in a few shower opportunities still, although a bit of a break at times in the Northwest, but the warmth continues to push across the U.S. It's going to be a pretty fine time of it temperature-wise on toward the weekend. No major complaints from that, but again, a brief break on tap for the Northwest, but across the Northern Plains, things will take a change for the cooler and also for the wintrier. This trough, some people call the jet stream the polar front. So as it moves northward to the south of it, warmer temperatures pulled up. That's what we get for New England. Across the Midwest and Northern Plains, well, that trough works to let some cooler air slink southward. Let's begin now breaking it down day by day. Northeast fairly quiet. Might kick up a few stray showers in upstate New York. Not that big of a deal. Scattered showers Georgia coast and southward. Again, expect to see problems there along the water. Could see the pounding surf there an issue for quite a while on Thursday, too. Stormy, too, across parts of Texas. May see an outside chance of something in toward Dallas, but far more likely in toward San Antonio and West Texas. It's going to be the thing. A few showers for the northwest, again, becoming a bit lighter during the daytime. Showers in toward Portland, Northern California, too. Friday, may see a little bit of lingering rain to Florida. We'll keep our eye on this particular area. Across West Texas, Hill Country, wet again. Northwest, still a bit soggy. Showers in Portland, Northern California. But look, here we go. Northern California is still a bit wet. Might see a little snow in portions of Oregon, on into a bit of Idaho, onto Montana. A little rain, could see some rain creeping in toward the Treasure Valley of Idaho. For the Northwest, again, a brief break. Sounds good to me. Wet across Florida still for Saturday and this Sunday. Some scattered showers that will kick up. Midwest getting a little wetter towards Chicago, Milwaukee too, even Buffalo. West Texas stays wet. But remember, we saw just a little protective influence building toward the northwest. Like the sound of that. But we will be dealing with a few snow showers, just a few, on the portions of Wyoming, for example. Part of the coast there might see a little chance of rain on a Monday. But throughout the Midwest and Northeast, across the Great Lakes, more rainfall. Detroit, Indy, Cleveland, Pittsburgh, even on toward Philadelphia, New York City, Boston, Hartford, and Providence could be wet. Lexington, Louisville, Kentucky, even toward Nashville, Tennessee, Knoxville, Gatlinburg, too. Could see some rainfall in that spot. On to Tuesday, just a little lingering rain and snow. See some showers in the Carolina coast, Northern California a bit wet, but we'll get back in that wet situation again for Wednesday. Even the Northwest getting a bit soggy, some snow for the Bitterroots. We could actually even see some snow in toward the Treasure Valley. Chance of seeing some here. And a little wet, too, parts of Florida. A few snowflakes flying in some of the areas across the Great Lakes. Just a little light snow, a little rain mixed in at times. Let's talk temps. I call this mild. I'd call it mild big time across most of the U.S. No bitter cold. Not really looking for an Arctic outbreak. We will be a little cooler. Parts of upstate New York into Friday, just a touch. Northern Plains, just a hint of cool air. Saturday on into Sunday. A little cooler, not bitter cold, but just a bit cooler. But some honest-to-goodness chill, highs in the 30s. Northern Minnesota might see that on in toward Monday. Overnight lows, same progression, pretty mild start to this day. Then temperature's not a major problem. A little cooler across the interior west. So upstate New York, after a few mild starts, will be just a little bit cooler. Not too cool for that early morning jog, though, across most of the country. That story, the big picture across the U.S., again, a lot to talk about with these three big storm systems. We'll discuss it further next, right after your local forecast. Please do stay tuned.
Don't you deserve to know the true story?
I worked for him, and I had to quit because he was having an affair with the secretary.
That's the one I see here, wavy hair, right?
Long, wavy hair, yes.
There she is. I had just turned the card when you were talking, and I saw her. You were afraid the police were going to get called on him.
I sure was.
He has an old rap sheet, doesn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ooh, Miss Cleo, you hit it on the head.
Call me for your free reading now.
Call 1-800-799-7239.
Great. Credit card bill. Wonder what's in here this time.
Look at these fees. One rate for purchases. Higher rate for cash advances. And those telemarketers.
Relax. We switched to Capital One's new No Hassle card.
Capital One.
Introducing Capital One's new no-hassle Platinum Card. No balance transfer fees and no telemarketing, plus one low fixed rate on everything from purchases to cash advances. Check your mailbox today and get Capital One's new no-hassle Platinum Card for one low rate and none of the hassle.
Honey, you okay?
What's in your wallet?
Your pet's exact same heartworm and flea medications delivered to your door for less than you're paying now.
It costs less than buying from my veterinarian.
Took less than 5 minutes to order.
You don't have to make an appointment. You don't have to miss work.
Now I call Pet Meds and get my pet's heartworm medication delivered right to my door.
The exact same flea and tick medications you get from your vet.
Only they're cheaper.
1-888-PET-MEDS. We deliver savings and convenience on HeartGuard, Advantage, Frontline, and all other pet medications. Call to order now or order online.
Make fast decisions with desktop weather by the Weather Channel.
Chief, can't cancel your golf game. Rain's coming. No, you demand.
Stay on top of things. Download desktop weather at weather.com. It's free.
Buying, selling, or building, more often than not, it's an emotional and financial drain. HGTV invites you to spend time with the experts as Location, Location, Location returns to prime time. Buy, sell, or build smart with Location, Location, Location. Tuesday nights at 10:30, only on HGTV.
So you think you're pretty tough. Well, guess what, tough guy?
You beat up your wife, your girlfriend, you could end up here.
A new law makes domestic violence a crime. And if you're convicted,
that gun of yours, gone for good.
You could serve some serious jail time, my friend. Believe me, you're not going to be so tough in here.
The new Domestic Violence Act. Lose your guns, lose your freedom, lose your respect.
It's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Currently, the temperature is 56 degrees under fair skies. Forecast for your area. Expect fair skies Friday through Sunday with temperatures in the 70s on Friday.